were in for. Hello, everyone. Orville Wright and Wilbur Wright, known as the Wright Brothers. We're American brothers who flew a powered airplane for the first time in history. First of all, let's talk a little about the background and childhood of these Wright brothers. Wilbur and Orville Wright were two of seven children born to Milton Wright, a clergyman of English and Dutch descent, and Susan Catherine Corner, of German and Swiss descent. Milton Wright's mother, Catherine Reeder, was a descendant of the Vanderbilt family, one of America's wealthiest families, and the Huguenot Gano family of New Rochelle, New York. Wilbur was born near Millville, Indiana in 1867, and Orville was born in Dayton, Ohio, in 1871. The brothers never married. The other Wright sisters were Roiklin 1861 to 1920, Lauren 1860 to 1939, Catherine Wright 1870 for 1929, and twins Otis and Ida born 1870, died in infancy. The direct paternal line goes back to Samuel Wright, who sailed to America and settled in Massachusetts in 1636. None of Wright's children had middle names. Instead, their father tried hard to give them distinctive first names. Wilbur Fisk and Orville, the clergymen whom Wilbur Milton Wright admired, were named after Orville Dewey. They were Will and Orv to their friends, and in Dayton their neighbors. Because of their father's position as bishop in the United Brethren in Christ Church, their father traveled frequently, and the Wrights moved frequently, a total of 12 times, before finally returning permanently to Dayton in 1884. Orville misbehaved and was expelled once. In 1878, while the family lived in Cedar Rapids, Iowa, their father brought home a toy helicopter for his two young sons. The device was based on an invention by French aviation pioneer Alphonse Penault. It was made of paper, bamboo and cork, and a rubber band to turn its rotor, and was about 1 foot 30 centimeters long. Wilbur and Orville played with it until it broke, and then they made their own toy. In later years, they pointed to their experience with the toy as sparking their interest in flying. On August 18, 1871, Alphonse Penault broke new ground in aviation by flying the first structurally balanced model airplane at 40 meters in 11 seconds in the Tuileries Garden in Paris, under the supervision of Société Aéronautique members. A toy similar to this had attracted the Wright brothers' attention as a child. In 1890, Wilbur and Orville Wright, two bicycle masters from Dayton, Ohio, began systematically studying anything that might give them clues about how birds fly. They soon realized that there was nothing in the scientific works and the experiences of ancient people that would be of any use to them. The Wright brothers started their work with the work of German engineer Otto Lilienthal, who only tried flying a glider from a hill near Berlin. Wilbur and Orville Wright were not scientifically educated, nor did they attend a college after high school. However, while they were carrying out their studies in the field of flying, they also advanced their own methods in this regard. Thanks to hundreds of experiments with model airplanes, kites, and human-carrying gliders, in order not to be left behind as a country by the developments in aviation, the Smithsonian Institute, USA gave Wenham John Browning's wind tunnel work of 1871, along with Lilienthal's lift and drag painting, to the Wright brothers in 1895, in order not to be left behind as a country by the developments in aviation. The Smithsonian Institute, USA gave Wenham and John Browning's wind tunnel work of 1871, along with Lilienthal's lift and drag painting, to the Wright brothers in 1895. Since Lilienthal studied the flight of birds very closely, it should not be surprising that her glider resembled a bird. Lilienthal demonstrated that an airplane capable of flying must have a fixed wing in contact with the air. The control necessary to achieve a stable flight could only be provided by such a wing, as he said, and the Wright brothers took Lilienthal's work as a basis in this regard. The Wright brothers' first plane, which took off under the control of Orville in North Carolina on December 17, 1903, was built adhering to the aerodynamic theory of sound. This plane had two propellers, and its weight, including the pilot, was 335 kilograms. On the first attempt, Orville flew for 12 seconds and covered a distance of only 37 meters. The Wright brothers had now created a plane that could fly. But they didn't know how to fly it. The Smithsonian Institution continued to convey to the Wright brothers all the information it obtained by corresponding with leading aviators Louis Mouillard, Gabriel Voisin, John J. Montgomery, Louis Bleriot, Alberto Santos Dumont, and Percy Pilcher. On June 4, 1908, the first official flight of the USA was made by Canadian Glenn H. Curtis, with a plane that could take off without outside help, which he named Junebug. This flight is America's first official heavier-than-air aircraft and flight. Rapid aviation developments in Europe and the U.S. War Department and the Smithsonian Institution, which started working with Canadian Glenn H. Curtis, would continue to market the Wright brothers, who had difficulty even starting the race, with first flight. On December 17, 1903, Orville and Wilbur Wright, or as we know them, the Wright brothers, made the first powered flight, after decades of work. Thanks to this short flight, we can travel around the world as we wish nowadays. Today, everyone would agree that the first powered flight of the Wright brothers was a very important invention. However, the interesting thing is that for decades, this success did not attract anyone's attention. Even the local newspaper in their area did not report their success, saying that the flight was too short to be significant. The first flight took place at Kill Devil Hill, North Carolina. On November 17, 1903, the brothers each made two flights that day. The first flight by Orville Wright lasted 12 seconds and covered a distance of 40 meters. Wilbur Wright, on the other hand, would manage to fly a total of 275 meters in 59 seconds. There are only 5 witnesses to these first flights. And as we said at the beginning, the news appeared in very few newspapers the next day. 6 months later, they invited the press to attend their 1904 flight. Unfortunately, mechanical problems and poor wind would not make this flight possible. Reporters were convinced that their previous suspicions were justified, and the Wright brothers were ignored once again. After their flight in Kitty Hawk, the Wright brothers returned to Dayton, where they built a second airplane to fly to. They made 105 flights with this aircraft in 1904. But these flights did not attract much interest. Flyer 3, an advanced and very useful model, was built in 1905. The brothers applied for a patent, but their achievement attracted almost no press attention. Even after all the flights they had made near Dayton, most people still did not believe that the airplane had been invented. Even though the Wright brothers made history, their plane was actually just a proof of concept. It could make straight-line flights, but the design did not yet have any practical use for society. Fortunately, the Wright brothers put an end to public suspicion in 1908. Wilbur Wright took one of the planes they built to France, made a series of public flight demonstrations, and arranged for a company to market his inventions in France. Meanwhile, in the United States, Orville Wright was organizing similar demonstrations to the ones in France. Orville focused on performing in his country to land a military contract. But in 1908, Orville's plane crashed, with Army observer Thomas E. Selfridge as a passenger. Selfridge died in the crash, and Orville suffered a broken leg and ribs, resulting in back problems and sciatica pain for the rest of her life. However, the successful flights of the Wright brothers convinced the United States government to sign a contract to purchase aircraft for the War Department. It's wise to be skeptical of the changes, but the media's lack of interest in the Wright brothers' flights had other reasons. In the late 19th and early 20th centuries, people took a pessimistic view of flying like birds. The brothers' momentum came to an abrupt halt when Wilbur contracted typhoid fever in 1912. Wilbur died a month later, at age 45. Without his brother, Orville stopped working on his airplane designs. Orville Wright sold his shares in the aircraft company in 1915 and lived until 1948. The press said that it would take decades for this to be successful, and the unsuccessful experiments of the Wright brothers supported their statements. However, history has proven them wrong. From shipping cargo to transporting passengers, to enabling future experiments in space exploration, The Wright brothers shaped the 20th and 21st centuries in many different ways. I hope the video was informative for you. If you liked the video, do not forget to subscribe to my channel and turn on the notification bell to be informed about new videos.